and welcome here. We have already started unit number 9, that is the Great Stone Phase 1. Very convincing and fascinating story it is. It is a story of a small child and he was living with his mother. He was attracted by that mountain, and there was a belief that that a mountain has a face of man, and it had a belief, means that village also had a belief that that the mountain, the man who just looked like that mountain will come shortly, and that man was very much rich and prosperous in business, and all the things were going on. Finally, that day came when the people of the village had that rumor that finally that man was coming. So let's see whether that man was coming or not. Okay, you are requested to keep a textbook with you. Actually, this unit is divided into two parts. We have part 1 and part 2. But in this part 1, we also have part 2. We are here on page number 123 and the first paragraph of that. Ernest had been deeply stirred by the idea that the great man, the nobleman, and the man of prophecy, after so many ages of delay, was at length to be seen in his native valley. Ernest is the name of that boy, and that boy had also a great interest for that mountain. So finally that man was coming, that rumor was there in the village, and Ernest was actually very much interested in to meet that prophecy man. While the boy was still gazing up the valley one day and imagining that the great stone face returned to his gaze, the noise of wheels was heard and a crowd of people cried, "Here comes the great Mr. Gathergold." So that was a gold man. Gold man in a sense means goldsmith. So finally that man was coming, and people were just calling that the man was coming, Mr. Gathergold. The name of that man was Mr. Gathergold. So everybody was telling that Mr. Gathergold was coming. A carriage drawn by 4 horses dashed round the turn of the road. Within it, thrust partly out of the window, appeared the face of an old man with yellow skin. Finally, that cart came to the village. That carriage was stopped there, and finally that man face was seen by the villagers. There, the very image of great stone face, shouted the people, and fortunately that man was just looking like same as that mountain. Sure enough, the old prophecy is true. Here we have the great man at least. People were very happy to see that man, and they were telling that finally that prophecy was coming true. And that man resembled just like that mountain. And what greatly puzzled Ernest, they seemed actually no belief that there was the likeness which they spoke of. He turned away sadly from the wrinkled shrewdness of that unpleasant face and gazed up the valley where the stone face seemed to say, "He will come, fear not, Ernest, the man will come." But Ernest somehow was not convinced by the face of that Mr. Gathergold. Ernest felt that no, that was not that man. Who looked like that mountain. So he was disheartened, he was sad, and he just went to that mountain. And stone face seemed to say, and it looked like that mountain was talking to Ernest. It looked like that, "He will come, fear not, Ernest, the man will come." So that mountain was telling Ernest not to lose heart, because that man who looked like mountain will surely come. Now part 2. The years went on, the Ernest grew to be a young man. He attracted little notice from the inhabitants of the valley. They saw nothing remarkable in his way of life, except that when the labor of the day was over. Here we got one word, that is inhabitants. Inhabitants means people living in the valley, or you can say dwellers. Let me write this new word. So many years passed, and he attracted a little notice from the inhabitants of the valley. They saw nothing remarkable in his way of life, except that when the labor of the day was over, he still loved to gaze upon the great stone face. So that now Ernest became young man, and nothing new was there in the village life and in the dwellings or inhabitants of that village. The only thing was common was that people used to gaze at that great stone face after coming from their labor work. Their idea was that this was a folly, but pardonable, because Ernest was industrious, kind, and neighborly. They did not know what the great stone face had become a teacher to him, and that sentiment which was expressed in it would enlarge the young man's heart. So, we got here one word, that is labor. Labor means work. People didn't know that what was that in that mountain that Ernest was so keen to for that. Their idea was that this was a folly, but pardonable, because Ernest was industrious. Industrious means Ernest was very hardworking. Here we got another adjective. Neighborly means very helpful, and Ernest was very kind too. They did not know that the great stone face had become a teacher to him, and that the sentiment which was expressed in it would enlarge the poor young man's heart, fill it with deeper sympathies than the old other heart. It means Ernest has deepest sympathy for that great stone face. People were also attracted by that great stone face mountain, but Ernest has something different, something a unique sympathy Ernest had for that mountain. Sympathies. It means feelings of sorrow, approval, understanding. So, it means Ernest has a great sympathy for that mountain, and he had an understanding, something different understanding he had for that mountain. They did not know that from this would come a better wisdom than could be learned from books. And people even didn't know that this understanding, this wisdom, this kindness, that neighborly nature of that Ernest is coming from that mountain. Because as we know, student, that mountain was not just a mountain for Ernest, it was a teacher for him. And Ernest was learning each and everything from that mountain. So the he Ernest had a very great wisdom at the tender age. So he was just something special for him. Neither did Ernest know that the thoughts which came to him so naturally in the fields at the fireside were of a higher term than those which all men shared with him. It means he was growing maturely, and even Ernest didn't know that the thoughts which were coming from that fields, which were coming from that mountain, was actually making him a matured, a wise man. A simple soul, simple as when his mother first told him the story, he beheld the marvelous face looking down the valley and still wondered why its human likeness was so long in coming. Beheld means so. So he was such a simple man. And he was that much simple man, means I'm talking about Ernest. Ernest was that much simple man that when first he just listened, or first he was told the story of that mountain, Ernest, that a great famous stone mountain, he beheld the marvelous face looking down the valley. Since then, he was just marvelous about this, about that face stone, and still wondered why its human likeness was so long in coming. See, that Mr. Gathergold, actually people were telling that Mr. Gathergold was the exact person who looked like that mountain, but not. No, that was not true. So still Ernest was waiting for that man who exactly looked like that face of that mountain. So he just didn't know that the urge of the meeting with that man having similar face of great stone of face. Please you note down these 5 words. After that we'll go further, students. Please note down. Next paragraph, page number 124. By this time, poor Mr. Gathergold was dead and buried. His wealth, which was the body and spirit of his existence, had disappeared before his death. Since the melting away of his gold, it had been generally agreed that there was no great likeness, after all, between the ruined merchant and the majestic face upon the mountain. So that Mr. Gathergold, now that Mr. Gathergold was no more. And his wealth, which was the body and spirit of his existence, had disappeared before his death. And before his death, all the wealth of his was disappeared. It means Mr. Gathergold was not at all helping that people. And prophecy was that this lucky man will bring a prosperity and will bring fortune to the people. But here that was totally opposite. Mr. Gathergold didn't help anything, and before his death all the wealth was gone. It since the melting away of his gold, it had been generally agreed that there was no great likeness after all between the ruined merchant and the majestic face upon the mountain. So now people realized that there was no any kind of likeness between Mr. Gathergold and that great stone face. It means that Mr. Gathergold was not the same person. Mr. Gathergold was not the prophecy man. He was not a person who looked like that great face stone. It was a rumor. Now people realized that thing after the death of Mr. Gathergold. It so happened that another son of the valley had become a soldier many years before. After a great deal of hard fighting, he was now a famous commander. Another thing was there now in the village, that another person, that another son of Great Valley had become a soldier, and that man was a commander in army. He was known on the battlefield by the name of Blood and Thunder. Old man and tired now, he had lately expressed a desire to return to his native valley. So now what happened actually? Another son of the valley, another son of that village was coming, and he was also a prosperous man. He was also a great man, and he was also having desire to coming back to his native place. The inhabitants, his old neighbors and their grown-up children prepared to welcome the renowned commander. Now what happened? People became crazy for that also. People started thinking that was the man who will bring prosperity to the village. So all the people, children and all the men and women from the village was starting welcoming him. It was being said that at least the likeness of Great Stone Face had actually appeared. Therefore was the excitement throughout the valley, and many people who had never once thought of glancing at the Great Stone Face now spent much time in guessing at it. So it was now guessing, or it was a belief that finally they were going to have that lucky man for their village, and that likeness of Great Stone Face was finally coming towards him. And what happened up to this, no one was care about that mountain, but now everybody was spending time with that Great Stone Mountain for the sake of knowing exactly how General Blood and Thunder looked. His name was Blood and Thunder. So that Blood and Thunder was coming towards valley, and people were excited to see the face of that old man, because they believed that old man has the resemblance of Great Stone Face. On the day of the general's arrival, Ernest and all the other people of the valley left their work and proceeded to the spot where a great banquet had been prepared. Banquet means feast. Banquet. So they all were welcoming that Blood and Thunder. See, first of all, who was coming? So first of all, it was that Mr. Gathergold. Now second type, the old man, that old soldier named Blood and Thunder. And everybody was welcoming him. Soldiers stood on guard, flags waved, and the crowd roared. Ernest was standing too far back to see Blood and Thunder's face. However, he could hear several voices. Finally, that Blood and Thunder man came. That soldier came. Everybody was so clapping, everybody was appreciating, and there was so much noise. Ernest was also there, and he was also excited to see the face of that man who was looking like a great stone face. It's the same face, exactly, cried one, dancing for joy. So people were there, and one of the men just told that, oh, it looked like exactly, it does look like that great stone face. And everybody started clapping. Page number 125. Wonderfully like it, that's a fact, replied another. Another man said that yes, it is wonderful that that man was looking like that mountain. And why not, cried a third. He is the greatest man of this or any other age beyond a doubt. Finally, they believed that they have got their lucky man. They have got their prophecy man. They have got their fortunate man. And people accepted that man. Ernest at last could see General's face, and in the same glance to the side, he could also see the great stone face. If there was such a likeness as the crowd proclaimed, Ernest could not recognize it. So now it was Ernest who was going to see that General's face. After seeing that face, he was looking towards that mountain face. But somehow he was not convinced. He couldn't recognize that. And again, Ernest was depressed. Ernest was disheartened. Ernest was sad because that soldier was also not having same face as great man, great stone. Fear not, Ernest, said his heart, as if the great stone face whispering to him, fear not, Ernest, he will come. And again, it was not he. Ernest just recognized. And people were proclaiming. Proclaiming means said loudly. Another word we have. So people were loudly telling that yes, they got their man, but Ernest was very much sad because that was not that man about whom Ernest was just waiting. So it was a voice from Ernest's heart that don't lose hope, Ernest, that man will come. It means still we don't know that man. That prophecy man, soldier was not that prophecy man. Okay, here we have completed this unit. You are requested to write these new words. After that, we'll go for the students. Please note down this. I think I should stop here, student. Let me give you homework. Your homework is you have to write these new words. Another thing I'm giving you, you have to write this true false. Okay? Comprehension check, which is there on page number 125. It is 6 true and false that you have to write, and you have to write the new words of this unit. We'll start that part 2 of the unit in next video. Please be connected. This is very interesting unit, and in part 2 we will see that whether that village got their prophecy man or not. Please take care. Bye.